Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. It's me, Mondragon, and on today's video, we are going to be reviewing another Spider-Man figure. And this one is the newer one that came out, which is the Amazing Fantasy Spider-Man. Now, this figure is pretty good, but the thing that's not good is the box. I don't like the box. The box is garbage. The box is mid. I don't like it at all. Now, let's jump into the box. Pulling out the coupe at the lot, 24-12 fuck swat, busting all the bells out the box. I just hit a leap with the box, had to put the stick in the box. Alright, starting off with the box, I do not like it at all. It's actually really basic. The side profile of the box is terrible. I don't like the back picture. I like this picture. This picture is cool. I mean, I think it's cool, but overall this box looks hideous.
Just in the neighborhood, but I mean, I guess.
So amazing.
The hoes don't think so, but it is what it is.
Can I thank you this time?
I guess. Hold on, bitch, you got AIDS?
No, not
hey. Ah! Who the fuck is this?
So starting off with the figure, I actually really like the detail. Well, there's not that much detail. It's a Spider-Man, obviously. But I love the red paint, and I love the black, like the black bluish kind of dark blue paint. I like the spider logo in the back, although I've heard that the logo is inaccurate because it was supposed to be blue. But other than that, I actually really enjoyed the detail of the figure. As you can see, it has a lot of joints, which means there's a lot of movement. I love the head, man. I love the eyes. I've always liked Spider-Man with just more squinty eyes. Let's get into the other part.
I'm Spider-Man.
So for articulation, his head can go all the way up. That's pretty good range, actually. Really good range. His head can go all the way down. His head can go side to side. He does have a little bit of head tilt, so that's pretty good. His arms can go up, not as far as I wanted, but still good enough. His arm does have a bicep swivel, and he does have a good butterfly joint. On mine, it's kind of stiff, but it's pretty good still. He has double jointed elbows. They're really good double jointed. His hands can move around. Well, I mean, they always can. They always are on a swivel too. He has like an upper, I don't know what they're called, the joints, but he has like a upper. Sorry about that. My camera died actually while recording this figure. But what was I talking about? Oh yeah, okay, so I don't know what this joint is called, but his ab crunch is really good. Like really good. And he can go back too. His kick is high. I actually really like that for his posing. He also has thigh swivel, which is really good. He has a good spread. He got double jointed knees, which is amazing. And he also has a boot cut, which is like every Spider-Man needs. And he has ankle movement. And he has an ankle pivot, which is standard for every Marvel Legends nowadays. For the articulation, I actually really like it. It's not the best. It's not like Mayfex level. Like one of my friends say, it's like, yes, it's a good figure, but it's like not Mayfex. I'm like, yes, but for Marvel Legend, this has to be easily the best posable Spider-Man.
Consider yourself lucky, Spider-Man. There's not many people in this world that get to enjoy this view of me in my leotard.
So for this figure, he actually comes with 4 web wings, 2 wall crawling hands, 2 flip hands, and 2 grabbing hands, which is amazing. So to take a closer look with the accessories on this figure, here's the Spider-Man with the, I think these are the closed webs, yes. These are the closed webs on his arms, and they actually have like a little peg. So you plug him in, and then you have his arms down, and he looks like he doesn't have his web wings on. And then when you have the web wings are opened, it looks like he's trying to glide, or he has his webs, like his arm up, and the web wing is just like sprouting out, or not sprouting out, but extending. I think it gives it more flair, but I'm not gonna keep it on mine, because I like mine without it. Thank you. to Spider-Man, Magnus Spider-Man. My previous review, here we got Andrew and Ben Reilly.
Holy fuck, it's Spider-Man!
Hold on a sec, this doesn't look like a party at all. The overall vibe is way too rapey.
So for my final thoughts of this figure, I really, really, really think that this is the best Marvel Legends Spider-Man. That's just my opinion, but I truly believe this is one of the best top tier Spider-Man figures of all time. I know that people will be thinking that the Renew Your Vows is the best, but it really isn't. It really isn't. That figure looks weird. He's too bulky, in my opinion. He's like too muscular for Spider-Man. I get that he's the older Spider-Man, but this guy right here, the Amazing Fantasy, is a good Spider-Man. And if you don't have this guy, or if you're not even thinking about getting him, I recommend getting this guy. I really do recommend him. He's one of the greatest Spider-Man figures. Of course, he's not like Mafex level of good, but I think if Hasbro did a couple more steps to it, it probably would have reached to that level because it's that good. And I know that most people won't agree with me, and that's fine. But I just think it is one of the best Spider-Man figures. I mean, it comes with good accessories. It has good paint. It has a good head sculpt, good body mold. I think it's one of the newer body molds. I don't think it's actually reused. I actually can't wait to get the Amazing Friends 3-pack. Because that one's actually the same body, but different color. And that's the one I want. But other than that, the box is hideous. I don't want to talk about much. Like, I don't want to talk about the box because, like, everybody knows it sucks. Those boxes are useless. I mean, I would like for them to go back to their old boxes, but I don't think it's going to happen sooner or later. But other than that, thank you for watching. Thank you for watching. I'm sorry about not posting as much. In my next review, I'm probably going to have a new setup. So just try to get used to that setup that I have. And I'll see you guys most likely next week. I won't slack anymore. So I'll see you guys next week. Please like and subscribe. Turn on the bell, actually. And have a good day. See you guys.
Raindrops keep falling on my head. And just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head. They keep falling.